Nothing is only a game. Ask anyone. The essence of any great game, tennis, chess, Sonic, anything, is the ability to lose yourself in it. Until there's only you in the game, and you're the one in charge. Your moves, your decisions will make the difference. Do it right, you're the hero. Do it wrong. Either way, it's your game. That's what this program is about. There's a whole universe of interactive media available today that'll let you do anything from learning French to piloting a starship.
We, the people of this show, must try Spock Bones, please.
It's a long way from that screen on the corner arcade. Yeah, it percolated there for a while at a quarter a pop. And then the technology it represented heated up through the spectrum.
Until it was Nova time.
Suddenly, you can't look around without seeing fallout from the same ideas that produced those first video console games in the 70s. This was more than just a way to suck coin from pocket. This is the way of the world today. It's changing the way we define learning. It's changing the way we define entertainment.
This is no longer just big business. It's huge business with no definable frontier. And it's as close as the end of your finger. Just push the button. The arcades are still there. And yes, the games will blow your head off these days. But the technology grew up. It moved out. It transformed. It went to school on computers and started with bean counting programs and ended as complete interactive learning experiences. It found a home in your pocket. In everything from portable game modules to personal digital assistants. Whether you realize it or not, that tired new term, information highway, actually does have some relevance to you. Some of the trails already lead into your home, and you've known how to drive for years. So drive!
Because that's how it's going to be played! There are no bystanders!
There's only you and the game, and you've got control.
Now, let's get right to it.
So all I've tried to do in my 21 years in Scientology, with the help of my church and the leaders of my church, is to take the opportunity to take the legacy of LRH's technology out into the world, to get on the comm lines of the world, and to actually do something to change the condition of my fellow man.
You know, there's a difference between reading LRH's references on psychiatry and then actually cognizing to them, and cognizing what that influence is really all about, and what an effect it actually does have on society and on mankind. And, you know, once you become aware of that, you just have to do something about it.
You know, when something like Scientology and Dianetics has saved your life and given you a new lease on it, you know, you really don't feel like you have a choice but to share it with people. I mean, it's that simple. This is a really important thing for mankind, and it's okay to help someone. And all I'm doing by disseminating is helping someone. I like these people too much to not have them have what I have. I know the end results of the dissemination is that they'll help others. And as a plan, I mean, you know, if you want me to quote the bigger picture, it's obvious. But the immediate picture is I want to help the guy in front of me. And that's all there is to it.
These IAS members took responsibility for Scientology and their fellow man. And we salute them on this 10th anniversary. The price of freedom cannot be paid by one man alone. LRH lit the torch of freedom. He passed it on to us, we all have the responsibility to carry it forth now.
It's more amazing than Reptile Boy found in swamp. More incredible than Bigfoot Mary's Hollywood star. It's Super Mario All-Stars is free.
I want to know how.
Just get the Super NES Super Set, and for $3.50 postage and handling, you can send for a free Mario All-Stars game.
I did it. Now look at me.
Four Marios in one, delivered straight to your house by alien postman. You'll play every Mario Brothers made. Retouched photos to prove it's true. Hurry, pick up your copy today. Super Mario All-Stars is free.
All right, I want to get this read because I'm not a monster. It's a little Kevin Spacey for you. Who doesn't remember Kevin Spacey's excellent role from whatever Call of Duty that was? Advanced Warfare. That is a pleasing boot sound. I gotta give it to the Dreamcast. I think they nailed that. Kind of reminiscent of GameCube in a bit. It's like percussion followed by a musical sting. As opposed to, like, just like the THX sound collage or the PS PlayStation line. PlayStation 3's was a bit ostentatious. Like, are we striking up the band? Like, PS2 boot music is easily the best. I don't know. See, That's core for a lot of people. Rightfully so, but I don't think I like the just like PS2 synth chime as much. Maybe it sounded too shrill out of my PC speakers. It was always just like a little much, a little intense. That's objectively wrong. I'll accept being wrong on this. I like the equalizer range of PS1 better. It's lows, it's highs. It's like it's meant to be masturbatory, and that's what makes it so good. PS2 is just so shrill, there's almost no bass in it. There's like, it's just the hard hit and then the swoosh, and it's all like, it's all treble, it's all upper register. Never really understood that. I forgot what I'm doing. I gotta go get my shit kicked in at the travel agency. It said 4 hours, but I went to sleep, so now I have to wait till they open. Which means, wait, what time is it? Is it late? Did I not? I didn't sleep. Alright, never mind. Hey, Kutanaga. Haven't changed from the PSX theme on my PS4 because I love it so much. Yeah. It's powerful. I try to force myself to form new connections, though. Like, I want the PS4 to have its own little spot filed away in my memory in addition to all the other ones. Not just, even though PS1 might be better. I like giving it its own identity. Even if it means maybe suffering. I'll say the word suffering. I got it working. Yeah, eventually. Sort of. It's been fairly stable. It's got some quirks, but those quirks end up being
Ine-san is always there for me.
Amusing. I like how he's still collecting money from his mom even though he just got a pretty good payday. It's had its own spot for a year. I may end up switching to a Persona theme. Man. I spent so much time in Persona, the menuing and sounds of that game definitely have their own place too, filed away in my brain. It's like that, the like battle and menu music from Final Fantasy VI, Earthbound, Final Fantasy Tactics. A lot of very intense music that loops really well. There's StarCraft, like Brood War and StarCraft II. Overwatch. Like, there's just some games that sort of have, just thinking about the audio. I mean, Mario for sure. Oh, shit. The roads are all snowy! It's making little crunchy sounds when I step! Thanks for the resub, Zaxby. Still rip your name. Man. Nobody's giving it up, huh? Is somebody trolling you, or did they just land on it and they don't even know they have your property? Need to finish Persona. I quit my job, so I finally have the time to do it. Yeah, get it in while you can.
Are you cold? Hey, see you soon.
I enjoyed that game, but it was a.
Are you cold?
It was a journey. Twitch just hasn't reapproved it. Oh, why do they have to reapprove it? You're on an all salami diet. It's winter.
Want some food?
Shinmu's the peak of... Wait.
She's eating!
PlayStation
she
shooters?
Very hungry.
That's true.
Yeah, and she looks real happy. Thank you, Dio.
You're only on the bank palace? Yeah, you got a ways to go. Ways to go. Speaking of Persona, you all need to see this. Oh, fuck. I can imagine where that goes. Somebody never saw it coming. Ugh. Got a receipt for Hack Boys, and I was like, what the fuck is this? What, is that what this is called? I filled that out so long ago at this point.
Dio-san?
Oh, what is it?
Ooh! Lucask!
Do you know anything about Asia Travel Company?
Thanks for the sub.
They don't have a very good reputation.
I'm gonna have to play a song.
You'd be better off
I'm gonna get to play a song.
Away from there.
I see.
Ooh. That's a hard bong. Alright. One sec. My candles. Oh, did Ryan just stop streaming? Did he finish God of War? He tweeted about it, right? Loading up all my CDs. Some Zaydoy. Yeah, Childish Gambino is on fire, huh? Alright, one second, I gotta do this. Good old F5. Wanna refresh? Oh yeah, to load up all the records, yes. There was a track. Heard. Yeah, whatever, I'll go with it. It's a basic pick, but sometimes you just feel basic. Alright. Thank you for the sub, My Alibi. It's a great name. Enjoy this track. My mic was muted. God damn it. I apologize. I got it wrong. Thank you for correcting me, Chris. Lucask, I'm sorry. I thought it sounded weird when I said it. I was like, that's not the same name. But I see it there. So my brain was like, don't worry about it. Just roll with it. There were two. I missed it. I apologize. Didn't mean to cheat you of your jam. What a horrible thing to do to someone. So I'm going to have a jam for you, too. It's kind of similar vibes, so here's a track for you. Thank you for subbing. We'll be right back. And Hopscotch Hank. Dang. Coming in with the 2 years of subs. Oy. Thank you so much for that. Always good to have you around. There was a pretty good... There's a good breakdown in the song. There it is. Yeah. Alright. This is a pretty good turn-up jam. Hopscotch, thank you. Please enjoy this track. Taxi driver asking what you just came into. It's me playing music for people that give me money on Twitch. I do it for some reason. I don't know why. Thank you, my alibi. I do it because I like music, and I like sharing music. I like listening to music. So it's an excuse for me to do everything I want all at once, which is get money, listen to music, and play video games. Although I have to not do one of those things right now because Stephanie got home and I want to go say hi to her. Memphisuga, I see your question. I will answer it in a moment. I don't want to make it sound like I'm ignoring you guys, but I want to go somewhere.
This award recognizes the vital contribution of actors in the creation of video games. Here are the nominees for Best Voice Performance by a Female.
Best Live Action Voice Performance, Female. Jenna Jameson, Grand Theft Auto, Vice City.
Yo, Candy, I'm looking for movie talent. You interested?
Sure. But you'd have to talk to my agent.
Allison Hannigan, Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
They cut the power. Does it make me a pessimist to say that's a bad omen?
Deborah Harry, Grand Theft Auto, Vice City.
You beat the crap out of them. Then they beat the crap out of us, etc., etc.
Mandy Moore, Kingdom Hearts.
When the Heartless came, everything changed.
Ms. Cleo, Grand Theft Auto, Vice City.
You must be the big bad man the granddaddy been chatting about. I wouldn't want to be in your shoes.
And the Glow Award for Best Voice Performance by a Female goes to... Jenna Jameson for Grand Theft Auto, Vice City.
Wow. I just wanted to tell everybody how excited I am to be included in the whole gaming tradition because I'm a big gamer, believe it or not. When I'm not working, I'm playing video games. And, you know, Vice City has to be the most amazing game that has ever been produced. I'd like to thank Rockstar for taking a chance on a porn star. Thanks, everybody. Party on.
Take it from a slipper expert. Isotoner slippers are for moms and girls. With unique four-way stretch that even gives little feet the feeling of a hug. That's Isotoner comfort. Isotoner comfort slippers for moms and girls.
Having the flu is a nightmare. Your throat's so sore. You're congested. You cough. Body aches all over. But now, there's Theraflu, the first and only hot medicine made just for flu symptoms. Theraflu, with a hot liquid like doctors recommend. Strong therapy for fever and cough. Strong therapy for aches and pains. Next time the flu strikes you, strike back with Theraflu.
Tuesday's terrific for the family that plays together.
Could anything be nerdier than this?
On Who's the Boss, then.
Face it, they were proud of me. I guess it was kind of by default.
The Wonder Years, and it's like a first date.
You believe in love at first sight?
No, but I'm only 20.
On Roseanne, then it's Coach.
I'm Honey.
Hi, Honey.
Hi, sweetie.
Join the all-star lineup. First on Who's the Boss and the Wonder Years. Then it's Roseanne and Coach. The Tuesday team is terrific.
Know what I like best about tap dancing? It's not ballet. I can practice on linoleum.
Okay, I'm back. I think there's been I've been staring at my journal for like half the day while this fucking dude has been here. Sorry, man. Actually, wait. Before you go somewhere. Wait. Hold up. So yeah. To the person asking about views on cheating, I guess? I don't know. I can like convince myself of two things. I think it's impolite. But it's also during play. So it's like, politeness doesn't really matter all that much. Like, if you don't like it, you can just leave type things. I think the thing is, it's when I think about it in terms of its like moral similarities, it's kind of like a prank where you have created an experience that's unfair or put somebody else in a weird situation to observe their response or to get like a power feeling out of it. And you're not letting them know that the deck is stacked. So they think it's a normal day, and then boom, there's a dinosaur, or they get hit with something. And it was like a planned thing on your behalf. That's kind of what cheating is, right? Like, you know you're violating the rules. They don't. And you're doing it to observe their reaction? It feels like pranks. They're called social experiments, sure. Either one, it is introducing negativity into someone else's life without their permission, which is sort of the fundament of being impolite. So I don't know. I don't do it, but I can't hold it against someone who does because I think the stakes are so low. I just wish I knew. Like maybe, I know it doesn't work this way on purpose, but if people that were cheating would declare it or like tell you after the fact. Because there's times where I've gotten really frustrated at a game that I presumed was on the level. And for all I know, there may have actually been hacking. I always told myself that people who like shout hacks, it's like, well, you're just... Like, look, people get lucky shots, alright? Like, there's that plus, maybe they're just that good. But some people... Was that Santa? Yeah, it was. This is like, it's really close to... It's Christmas Eve, dog. Of course Santa's gonna be walking around. Well, I gotta say hi to Nozomi. Walked up, turned around again.
Nozomi.
Ryo, take care of yourself.
Sure.
Thanks for the answer. I thought Bruce had an interesting take, but I was curious what you had to say. Yeah, Bruce does have an interesting take. Not incorrect. That store is a tomato? You bet it's a tomato. Gotta stop in. Whoa, it's cold out there. There we go. Nope. Yeah, that's it. Hey, what's up, Propulsive Goat? I just realized there's not going to be anything in here I don't have already. Get some sliced fish for the cat. That'll be nice. That'll be the cat's Christmas gift.
Yo, may I help you?
This.
Oh, I should get some milk, too. Man, gonna be a red letter day. What's up, Bitters? So cool, the music's freezing? Nice. I played for another software dev position and received an offer. Congratulations, Versus. Is it... Why were you playing for the position? Was it a pay raise and stuff like that? That's great. How are you celebrating?
Yo,
that's before you... But you missed it. How's the podcast been lately? Last time I was here, you seemed conflicted with what direction to take it in. I've been happier with it, but it's been performing worse. So, I think there are a number of creative calls that I can see that may not have been the best, but it's like, gosh, it just gets so, so mind-numbing to do the same thing.
Minako-san.
What?
Do you know anything about Asia
And it's like...
Don't you know?
I wasn't changing things because I was bored, but I was changing them because I thought they would help. And I thought they did, but I think there were a number of incidents that hurt viewership a lot.
I see.
They raise more benefits. It's closer to me. Way more affordable to live there once I get through the intro period. $8 raise. Nice! Congrats! Pop my finger for the first time since I broke it today. The motion is still limited, but I think I've regained enough mobility to go ahead with my golf trip in 2 weeks. Woo! Cool. Well, I'm glad it seems like it's healing. Oh yeah, the Asia Travel Company. Right. Dude Soup and H3 keep you going at work? Man. Yeah, see, like, you see numbers that H3 gets, and you're just like, fuck me. Ugh. What do I gotta do? I mean, I know what it takes, but... Loving the podcast, haven't missed one since I started college last August. Well, thank you. I'm not necessarily looking for validation. I'm just kind of confused. We had a thing that worked for a long time, and then... I think there were a couple weeks that were off, and I can see why somebody who was like just kind of enjoying it might drop out at that point. They're like, oh, they had a bad experience, and then next week it's like, well, I could play this or two other podcasts that are on my phone. I'll play those, or like what you click on YouTube, stuff like that. I get that. That makes sense to me. I wouldn't hold that against anybody either. It's just I don't know how to move the needle back. Like before, you can have bad experiments on YouTube, but usually you can recover. Like gameplay stuff, it's like one video is bad, fine, next week is a different video, different title, different everything. So it's, yeah, and it's just a hard sell in general. There's less content on the channel, so less people are seeing other videos, so less people are inclined to click on this one. But that's a notable thing. Love the podcast, sucks to hear. There's nothing wrong with it, it still sells. That's why I have a job. It's because it's not, like, success is not default. Oh, shit.
Help you.
Yeah, Ryo Hazuki, I'm here for my ticket.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Oh, boy.
My Hong Kong ticket I've already paid.
Paid who?
The woman who...
Woman? Don't know no woman.
What? What kind of scam is this?
He's using his big dad voice.
Take kindly to accusations like that. You best learn some manners. Hey, you. You'd better watch your mouth.
I didn't even have to hit buttons.
I've had enough of this. I've already paid my money.
I understand. Allow me to sort this out.
You'd better, or else.
Yes, sir. I'll call you first thing tomorrow.
There's just gonna be more dudes. There's a reason Dude Soup doesn't go up on Spotify. I was told it was on Spotify, Woot. When's the last time you looked? Because I think it got listed on there 2 months ago or so? I gotta wait another day. God. No? Okay. Oh. Mini calculator. I always wanted to say hello and thank you for the great content. Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
Excuse me.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Tell me about your burgers.
How's business?
Well, I don't get as many customers as I'd been expecting, you know. I got my own place all right, but the restaurant business isn't easy. I'm confident about the quality of my burgers, though. I use quality beef and buns. My pickles are homemade, you know.
I see.
What's happening with the podcast? nothing. Nothing's happening. Just a viewership dip. We've had those before. I try not to panic. It's tempting when something moves, it's tempting to want to, like, reinvent everything. To be like, this isn't working. Throw it all out. Start over. But, I need to learn patience. Also, to be honest, like, views aren't as important. I mean, everything should get views. That's never a thing that doesn't happen. But it is interesting in that the podcast's value is that it sells direct ads. And that's more dependent on conversion than on viewership. It matters, but if, like, you can have, get some nice coffee for this cold weather. I don't know if it's going to be warm or not, but it seems right. You can have 100,000 viewers, listeners. You can have 1.5 million. But if like Casper runs ads on your podcast and you sell 10 mattresses and the other podcast sells 10, that's the same in their eyes. And they can probably get you for a little bit cheaper too. So that is a revenue stream is interesting. Very interesting. Different kind of ads, different kind of market. Watch the podcast, but I can never watch live. It's always during work or class. Well, hey, I appreciate it. No, it's... sadly can't control the time too much. That's just a good spot for us. Is there between listening on Spotify or somewhere else because I listen on the podcast app? No. We should...
Merry Christmas!
As far as I know, we can track all that, so... Don't worry about that.
Oh, hello there. There's a special Christmas menu at Aijiichi Chinese Restaurant.
It's
only available during the Christmas holiday. What do you say?
Some other time.
No, yo, that sounds delicious. Are the side missions in this game is the only way to pass time playing in the arcade, buying shit, and dicking around talking to people? The latter, Chromehusk. There is no side stuff. You progress story and that's it. I think that there are, like, different conversations you can have based on who you talk to and when. But it, yeah, there's...
Noriko.
There's no, like...
What's up?
Go find 20 crests or...
What are you up to?
Save someone's dog.
Oh, just thinking. Wondering why Eddie is so upset.
Eddie?
Yeah. But
Camera.
She won't say why.
Camera.
I think it's about Nozomi.
There he is.
Do you know anything about it?
Me? No, I don't.
I see.
Noriko.
Oh, Dio, why do you think Eddie is so upset?
I wonder.
I see.
Well, got to go now.
Right.
You need to buy your sponsor's products
Bye
to save the podcast,
now.
So she makes sure you know I'm joking. Yeah, no, I'm never going to ask anyone to...
Eddie?
What?
That kind of violates a...
Listen, Dio, you know, Nozomi... She still seems upset.
It bugs me when people leverage...
She starts crying. I wonder what's
leverage
wrong
that?
With her.
I don't know.
Come on.
Maybe this is an ego thing, but I like to think, you know, get your house in order. You shouldn't have to directly appeal to people's emotions for monetary support. If you're not making... So, like, the way that translates is I personally, as long as I can, won't say, like, we need you to do this. If I'm not making something that earns its own money under, like, without bringing, I'm trying to think of what the word is to describe that, of sort of playing on people's emotions or like, playing up a story of hardship to get more support. Went to work to earn your money on its own merits? Yeah, I think that's it. Divorced of my situation or the condition... the product is made in. I'd still like the entertainment product or whatever to be enjoyed. It shouldn't need an outside narrative to reinforce its value, I guess is specifically what I'd say. So it's let's see here, I want to find Aijiichi. Isn't this it? No, Soba. I don't think I've been in here. So yeah, I mean, there may come a day where the situation changes, and also, to an extent, I have the luxury of saying that. But yeah, there would never be something like, guys, you gotta buy these dick pills or Dude Soup's going away. If it were that case, Dude Soup would just go away, you know? But it's not the case, so don't worry about that. It carries more ad inventory.
Hello. Ah, it's Dio. Come on in.
Excuse me.
Is he smoking?
It's nothing.
Awesome.
What is it? What happened?
I'll come again.
Dio gets very awkward around cigarettes. They want to manipulate people? I guess. I wouldn't consider that manipulation. Because nothing's untrue. To me, I guess that's manipulation. Manipulation is selective showing of information or altering of information to make a story or a situation appear differently than it is. Yeah, for that hustle. Damn right. The post show is best? Packers, you think so? I was just thinking, now that I was thinking about today, just super passively, but just being like, huh, I wonder if there's anything I can do to make post show a little more interesting. Doesn't seem to get all that much attention on Reddit or on the Rooster Teeth website. I guess it is first only, though, so it doesn't really get posted. But you would rather the work you put out stay afloat on its own merits? Yeah, I guess that's a way of saying it. Alright, Ajiichi. I want that Christmas meal. Alright, down here on the left. What it's worth, since you have clarified your stance on HIMSS, I get it. HIMSS does seem like a great service for those who need it. Yeah. I guess I can see why certain reads may have given the impression it was being marketed as a recreational thing, or a way to playfully circumvent playfully circumvent anything that might, like, that might endanger one's health recklessly. I guess is, let's see it. Oh, it's on the other side. The tough thing is, and this is one of those things too. Sometimes it's real hard to treat the internet like a lot of people and not one voice. But there were people who were. It's like the bad part of internet mob stuff, where people, like fucking busybodies, basically, gossip. Because they get a charge out of being the center of attention, or because they feel a righteous indignation, they'll start to like twist certain things to make their side seem more righteous and the other side seem more evil. So someone comes into the subreddit, hey, what happened? Rooster Teeth selling drugs to kids. Like, what the fuck, man? It's not that even a little bit. And it's just all the verbiage and the wording that got used got more and more, like, harsh.
Tao-san.
It was just people building themselves up.
Have you been busy
and
lately?
No one well, trying to defuse anything.
Do you want something to eat? No thanks. I was just passing by.
We'll treat you.
No thanks. I'll come again.
We'll be looking forward to it.
Tao-san.
That was just super disappointing.
Would you like some food?
Because I always hoped that
I don't have any rice at the moment. Have some noodles.
That the way that
they'll be ready in no time.
The way that we treat the audience.
I'll come again.
Right. See you next time.
I think we were always pretty respectful to our audience, and we like turned down a lot of sponsors in the past. And it's one of those like parent things. Like we did a lot of stuff we didn't have to do to try and be good to people, and then to have them flip and be like, "Man, you're just taking advantage of us." That's one of those like when you're raising a teenager, you're just like. Paid for your ass to be here for 15 years, and now you're like saying these things to me. Like it's not like I guess parenting involves condescension. It's not that. It's more of an equal thing. It's just like, let's say you have a tight bro, like you guys are good. You've been through a lot of stuff, but then you're like, oh shit, I forgot my wallet, and he's all of a sudden he's like, what the fuck, man? You're like, what, man? I'll pay you back. It's just $5 for a burger, and he's like, no. Alright, fine. And he like doesn't, he's like, I can't fucking believe this shit. Like, this is totally irresponsible of you. And he like lays into you and you're like, why are you treating me like some asshole who just tried to rip you off?
Is it busy?
Thought we had an understanding.
A little. Wanna have a seat?
Nah.
Tried to point out on Reddit that people were being extremely reactionary and got downvoted into the void. People literally just wanted to be mad. Yeah, people got the whiff of the righteous kill.
Something to eat? Have a seat at one of the open tables.
And that shit is
no thanks.
Intoxicating.
Maybe next time. Bye.
Come again soon.
Like, I get it. Some people made their points well and expressed valid concerns. Others were way more active than they needed to be and were on every single comment, like making sure that people knew just how awful we were. Just And it was amazing to see. It's just like once that gets in, once those people dedicate themselves to it, they sway a lot of people. And it's really effective. It was really fascinating to sort of see it happen. To see the sentiment shift as a very few but very active people were spreading negativity as intensely as they could. And I had it out with some of those people. Basically made it clear that, like, no, I know, like, you may not know you're doing it, but you're one of the people. You're one of those, you're one of them. You're one of the, like, 10 or 12 people I see that are hammering this. You're on a campaign. And you're not keeping it between you and me. You're making sure everyone gets swayed to your side. It works. So, I guess that was, for me, one of the disappointing things was seeing that happen and be powerless to stop it. Jeff's speech on Off Topic was incredible. Yeah, that's the thing, man. Some people that wanted, like, I even saw some people reacting to that and being like, huh, so they just make people feel bad and all of a sudden no one cares. And it's like, wow, you found a way to spin somebody being as vulnerable as I've ever seen someone be. You spun that into making yourself feel superior. Into casting us back into this mold that you have. Sure, if you want to be cynical, yeah, it was meant to diffuse tension, but I think it was an honest reach out to say, listen, this is why we thought this isn't a good service for the right people. And to just have someone like wave it away was disappointing. And yeah, what forever baffled, the methodology is common elsewhere. Yes, it is. This is the new internet mindshare game. And the weapons are powerful. They work. This is the thing, though. People are going to have to develop antibodies. Like, you need that. People have to develop that mental barrier. Or it's like, or we, and I, like, we in terms of the people who sometimes push back against that wave, have to discover tools to dissolve it, to de-escalate. And it's tough, man. It's so much easier to make people mad than it is to make them happy again. That's just not in our nature. In a game. I've been a fan of RT since 06 and a sponsor for years, and all I ever for is advocate more free content for non-sponsors. It's how RT started and how RT should be. More free content for non-sponsors. Makes sense.
Guess I'll try it.
The thing is, I mean... Yeah, I agree. I guess the trade-off is Rooster Teeth does fewer things if more things are free. So it's tough. Because the more sponsors we have, the more people we can hire, and the more projects we can make. The more experiments we can make. More tests. They're not all going to hit, but if you don't swing, you never make anything. I think Rooster Teeth has pretty good batting average. Okay. Oof. It always takes me a second to relearn how to play goddamn Hang-On. I gotta admit, I'm getting pretty decent at this game. I was fairly certain I was gonna wreck as soon as I said that. Sign in the backstage, Dobuito? That's an area I should know. It does. Fuck. First thing I ever saw was Ruby. I really need to catch up on Ruby. I'm like halfway through season 3, volume 3. Like sponsor only stuff, saying sponsor only. I feel like it keeps a huge portion of community alienated, like, oh well, maybe you should have paid extra for this, like, make it free after some months, a year, if that makes sense. Oh, I hear you. Okay. Yeah, windowing makes sense. That's what we try to do with most of the content we make, is... Ah, dead. Did he give a peace sign before he collapsed dead? But yeah, it's... Most of the content we make now has a weak window on first. Fuck. So yeah, it's an interesting question. Ideally, everything's free, and everyone likes you enough, so much, that they're willing to get a first membership just out of gratitude. Oh, running out of time. Ideally. But, I can only trust that the people who are making that decision have data that says that's not really how it happens. Slow down before entering turn and then accelerate through the turns. That makes a lot of sense. That is how you're supposed to do a bike, actually. Can't even remember. Lots of break for that, whatever. It's not a complaint or anything, I get the business side of it, but for being a fan for so long it just hurts to see a divide, so I get it. So I get it, though. Hey, I love it all anyway. Yeah? Yeah. When you mean divide, do you just mean in terms of available content or in community? Literally a quote from my first motorcycle session back in the day. Yeah, well, I mean, it's a video game, right? But I guess it was probably more sim than not. I just assumed it was like every other racing game. Yep, I made my bike fall over by braking while turning. Bad idea. So, Candles, you're taking lessons? God, I guess I'll buy some capsule toys? That's why I think y'all nailed Twits and Crits when you had the free cut-down versions and the full versions for first members. Yeah, I don't know if that worked. That's the thing. They're...
Toy capsules. 100 yen each, huh?
It is conceivable that, that didn't work, and that's why it wasn't done again.
100 yen each.
Waste of time and money.
I should buy one.
Oh, you can't afford to have one in the state you live in because it's so seasonal? Yeah. It's, why does it sound like that? That is the quirk of the very real Dreamcast I'm playing on. Sometimes it does that. I can fix it by tabbing out and back in.
Great!
What is that even from? This constant winter makes owning a motorcycle lots of work. Yeah, I can imagine. It...
Maybe I should get another.
Like, it can maybe get 50 degrees by the ocean, and that is still very cold at night. Especially because I'm on an electric, and like it doesn't get hot, so there's no motor.
This is cool.
This is very cool. Good job. I always hear people talk about Shenmue, but people don't seem to discuss Shenmue 2 that much. Is it good? Another. I really liked it. I think maybe a lot of people didn't finish Shenmue, so they didn't play Shenmue 2. I think. It was also kind of harder to get in America. It didn't come out on Dreamcast. Microsoft eventually ported it. But it was with a Shenmue 1 and 2 pack, as I recall. So I would guess a lot of people started Shenmue, didn't finish it, and then just never played Shenmue 2.
Maybe I should get another.
So I think a lot of people just never ended up playing it. Like an artificial divide. Like, for example, Minecraft having a week delay between the first and regular the day earlier was good because it was something you could hype up on. Now it feels so easy to move on and forget earlier content and no longer have that fun connection in the moment. Also happened with Heroes and Halfwits. That makes sense. If the audience is watching two different videos at different times...
Maybe I should get another.
It's like, a week later, you're not going to remember all the things in that video, so you can't really talk about it with people who just watched it. Yeah, that makes sense. I never thought about that aspect. Hey, Turquoise. That's worth bringing up. Maybe it's weird from a programming standpoint. You'd think like, oh, a longer window is better, no matter what, because that makes a first membership more valuable if you have to wait longer. I didn't think about the splintering of the community or the conversation and excitement around particular releases. Gonna do ARAM candles? Alright, good luck.
I should go home and wait for Jimmy to call.
Alright. I think you said that because I was trying to go to the other zone, not because it was a particular time.
Oh, you should go home.
Eddie?
What?
Oh yeah, Eddie.
Listen,
the girl who's always mad.
You know, Nozomi, she still seems upset. Whenever I try to ask her, she starts crying. Do you know anything, Nyo?
I don't know.
Come on.
Boy, you're a dumb idiot. I just realized the movie that came with Shenmue 2 was Shenmue 1. Yeah, that was their attempt to get people to play Shenmue 2. I was like, well, what if we just give people a movie of like all the events so they can just see all the cutscenes, skip all of the weird downtime, and then they'll just jump right into Shenmue 2. And Shenmue 2 is the better game. It's bigger, there's more to do. Graphics are a little bit better, as I recall. I played it on Dreamcast, so it was probably even better on Xbox. Also, people don't give... I guess the bets never pan out, but Microsoft really did try to put some bets on some cool Japanese games, and no one gave a fuck. They did Jet Set, Shenmue 2, a couple of other ones, where they just, like, they published really quirky Japanese titles, Metal Wolf Chaos. Like, they were publishing FromSoft before Sony scooped them up, and, history would be an interesting place if their timing was inverted. Like, if they did Demon's Souls when they were publishing through Microsoft and it was an Xbox exclusive? That'd be weird. I guess they did Ninja Gaiden, too, now that I think about it.
Hey.
Hey, mister! Let's play baseball!
Some other time, okay?
Also, the first community now has more reason to move away from the regular community because the regular isn't caught up. They can't get excited together. I can see the business aspect of it, incentives for first. I honestly feel it hurts community communication and intrigue together. No, that's a really interesting perspective. I'll bring that up. You know? I think that's worth thinking about. Because, yeah, I mean, if you're in those communities and you feel that separation, that's not a good thing. I think if you wanted to be ultra business about it, you would... Here's how you would spin it. If you're a slick Rick Machinima dude, you say, yeah, but that just makes people want to be in the cool club, right? That just makes more people who want to be, like, super sweet first members, right? So, it does our marketing for us, you know? We don't have to do it. We just keep them separate. I'm like, man. Woof. All right. I was always... There's definitely a time where, like... There's definitely a time where somebody who makes a thing forgets what it's like to use the thing. Or even like the thing. It just becomes a thing. It happens so slowly. To the point where you're just... You don't understand anymore that people can just fuck off and do whatever they want. There's always a really weird, comfy assumption that you have a captive audience all the time. And it's just like, oh man, no. We gotta do everything in our power to make this place welcoming. Because if we don't, somebody else is gonna say, yeah, come over here. Come over here. And they will, because there's nothing stopping them. It's better. I was wondering, do you guys have the fun filming theater mode? Where the movie's a bore and painful to sit through? I really enjoyed it. I love watching horrible movies. Although, it is interesting what a subtle difference there is between something you can't even see and hear. And a film that at least is viewable and makes chronological sense and tells a comprehensible story. Sometimes the trauma stuff dips too hard into the, this is just functionally broken. This is a audiovisual disaster. Brova, what are we talking about? Just recently about theater mode.
Nice enough to bring those flowers.
Nozomi brought
Jacob. That definitely
she even remembered
similar shit. I like bad movies, and I like Shenmue. This is a bad movie. It's stilted. Really? It's awkward. The acting is horrible. The
she
writing is
such a nice girl.
A bore, kind of. But There was a Shenmue MMO, Riley. I remember that. Yes, that never got off the ground. I think they called it an MMO at the time, but it was just kind of like multiplayer Shenmue, is I think all I ever remember people describing it as. Can't watch any of the theater modes, even though I like Funhouse and Achievement Hunter. Why is that? It's too awkward for you? I was kidding, this game is a classic. It's a classic for its time. Like, you... It's not a classic like Super Mario Brothers is a classic. Anyone can play Super Mario Brothers, and it's always great. Because it is a classic. This is a game that requires explanation and context. Which kind of makes it not a classic. Just for me. More of a cult classic, yeah. Weeb Juice, that is the exceptionally correct way to classify it. It's, you know, it's a movie that does something brilliant. But that brilliance is not timeless, I think is probably what... how I classify it. Kind of like Batman Forever. Because like all things, this is now about Batman Forever.
Ine-san.
Dio-san. I don't wish to meddle, but please don't do anything reckless.
Okay, thanks. See you later, Ine-san.
Yes.
Movies where you can't remember a character's name and things just happen for no reason. Pretty sweet movies. I just ordered a pretty sweet movie on Amazon. I want to try to do something with it. I don't know if we can, though. Maybe we could do a theater mode on it? Maybe theater mode live or something? Did you hear the information on Nintendo's online system? Yeah, I talked about that on Dude Soup. It was cool. That's kind of what I think a lot of us predicted that they would eventually do. Just put their library behind a subscription wall. Makes a lot of sense. And I think they're clamping down on the library pretty hard to start off with. It's wild how many times they get to hit reset on that revenue. They're so smart about it. So smart about it. Was that this week's Dude Soup? Not that specifically. I mean, it was more Thanos. Thanos in Fortnite, because of course it was. Alright, it's Christmas Day! No, it's not. Did I not sleep? How can I never remember if I sleep or not? I don't think the option was there. I'm surprised by how cheap the buy-in is for Nintendo Online. Yeah, I saved. There we go. Gotta wait for that bro to call me. Who is this? That's not Nozomi at all. It's the girl from the game intro. What? Magical. You guys play more Yakuza 6? Probably not. I need to check and see how that first video did. If it performed well, probably wouldn't be the hardest of sells. It's Christmas! Stupid bit to steal, but God, that was so fucking funny. Is he gonna call me on Christmas? Shit, yeah, he will. Alright. It's too bad, I thought it was a great video. I thought so too.
Hello? Hazuki Dojo? Huh? Asia Travel Company?
Give me that.
Okay, just a moment.
Hello?
It's Jimmy from Asia Travel. I've got your ticket.
Yes.
I'd like for you to come and pick it up.
Yeah, he's not going to stab me. No.
Please come to the U Arcade on Dobita at noon.
I'm already there. Awesome. Let's see you guys going to the Yakuza 6 in-game webcam girls game.
The ticket. To Hong Kong.
Yeah, I got to watch a
I see.
Softcore tape on stream.
Oh, okay.
Chat was uncomfortable. Going to the arcade, Mom. Probably not gonna get killed. Oh yeah. I get to give a Christmas present to Mimi. suits exchanging again. I think this is where you run into the spider dude. Could be homeless man. Hello, Mimi. Got a Christmas gift for you.
Want some food?
Look, Dill. She must like it.
Yeah, she'll recover faster if she eats.
She likes everything.
You're right. Thanks, Dill.
Always heavy arms? That's kind of how he moves.
Here, drink up.
Bless you.
It's good.
His arms are packed with kung fu weight.
She's drinking!
Karate fury.
She must have been very hungry.
Yeah, and she looks real happy. Thank you, Dill.
Why is this child standing outside in the snow?
Are you cold?
There's a cute kitty here.
Hi, Megumi.
Hi, Dill. Hey, Dill. Guess how old Mimi'd be if she were a person?
About 3 years old?
Nope, she's about 5.
Is that so?
I looked it up in a book about cats.
Good for you.
Leave this place right away. Never gets old, no. It's beautiful. So many animals just hanging out. It's actually kind of nice. Ritual fighter. Oh, yeah.
Toy capsules. 100 yen each, huh?
I should buy one.
Oh, it gets into you. The need for capsules is strong. Calls to you on moonless nights. Oh, this fucking thing? I think I already have this.
It's the same one.
He's so pissed. God damn it. Another Bin's Bane.
Let's the audio. Try again.
It's normal. That's how the game sounds.
Huh?
16-ton weight. Heavy bomb! Yeah, one more. Playing this on emulator. Really want to play Shenmue. I need to get my Dreamcast out of storage. I am playing on an emulator. Slowdown is so frequent. Yeah, Laronic, it's high and low. Oh, shit, yeah!
It's the same one.
Oh, wait, I already had this? Is it Eggman or Robotnik? Alright, we're sticking with that. I gotta keep buying until I get it.
I should try again.
I should. Thank you, Ryo. Thank you. I'm glad we're on the same page here. Feels great. Alright, what is this thing? It's just a yellow ball?
Hey.
Yeah, that's kinda lame as hell. It's just a yellow ball. Super ball. That doesn't look very super.
I should try again.
Yeah, I should. This is how you're spending Christmas? Buying capsule toys for myself? Is that a dice again? Damn it.
This again?
Just quietly swearing at the dice machine or the capsule machine all night.
I should try again.
Nah.
Changed my mind.
Yeah, I decided not to. That was me. See what's in the Abe store. What is the point of the capsule machine? Ah!
Ma'am.
You saw it.
You're always full of energy, aren't you? Little suede-headed Duel has really grown up.
Please don't call me little suede-headed Duel.
I'll think about it.
The collectibles are in the... Yeah, you can just look at all your dumb things. Like a sweet X button. from Excite QTE 2. The sweetest hedgehog? The crude dude himself, Knuckles. Oh, and it even tells you how many you have. I got two ninjas. Nice. You're damn right that's Knuckles. This game takes place in a post-Knuckles world. It's like... actually, wait, it doesn't. Now that I've said that, I've realized that that's actually entirely false. This is a pre-Knuckles timeline. That Knuckles is thoroughly anachronistic. Why is there shit on the floor? Clean up your goddamn store. Piece of, it's garbage in here. Disgusting. You're human trash. You think if Shenmue 3 will have terrible MCVO, or will Sega actually try? So that's what's weird. I don't know. Could it somehow be like a high-res modern version of this? Which is like all kind of weird and awkward and stilted and just B-grade? And if so, can you even do something like that on purpose? I'm fascinated. I'm fascinated with how it'll turn out. I think once you see gameplay or trailer or anything, it'll become pretty clear what the intention is. If they're trying to make something realistic and swinging at it again, or if they're making a bigger, broader version of this, where you still just kind of wander around, talk to people. Like, are there going to be more capsule machines? Are there going to be more side things to do? Is it just going to build out that way? Or is it going to be fundamentally more robust in terms of its game world? Or its, like, conversation systems or whatever? Could go the Spyro and Crash route. Yeah. That makes sense. It's like, what if we made a game with this... like, even animations and stuff are different. So you don't get this weird, like, hand-animated run cycle. You could actually do mocap and stuff like that. I think they were just getting mocap then. I don't know where I'm running. I don't think the arcade is not this way. I went the wrong way. What's everyone's view on Detroit becoming human? Just... played the demo, and I'm in love. It looks so interesting. I guess that is the closest thing to the modern equivalent of Shenmue. Welcome, spool boys. I guess I'm getting spooled. I don't think this kind of exploration game style would work these days. The internet makes the answers more accessible. Yeah. I mean, this game... excuse me. Unlike other point-and-clicks, this game doesn't really... it doesn't strand you too much. Most of the stuff is pretty findable, and it's not these intentionally obscure combinations of items or sequences of things that are just impossible to divine on their own. The game is beatable without a guide. I did beat it without a guide, I'm pretty sure. So... I don't sense the intention of it to be like that, or that they think that that's the value of the game. I don't know if like 1050 is close enough. It is.
Huh?
No, Jesus.
Yeah! Came for your Hong Kong ticket, did you? Yeah, but you are not going to Hong Kong!
Do you work for Lundy?
Me? Work for Lundy-sama? That's my dream!
What do you want with me?
You know about Julianda. Tell me all you know. Lundy-sama hates Julianda, so I'll be rewarded for this information.
So you know about Lundy. Just who the hell is he?
only tell you if you prove stronger than Christ. Me.
I remember this fight actually being really tough. Or just kind of broken. Because I remember it taking... Like, I remember seeing that intro cutscene a lot. Of him being like, Juyonda! Because, yeah, you can't really move... You can't move around. God, this fucking sound effect. Yeah, he just like parries shit randomly and... Yeah.
Ryo-san!
Or maybe I kept reloading it.
I'll save the gun for later!
Because I was curious if you could beat him. Maybe that was it. I do remember seeing that intro cutscene a lot. Like it was definitely filed away in my brain. Oh, whatever. The game keeps going. I'm not gonna...
Just take it easy and rest today.
This game like Kingdom Hearts where you have to listen to the same shit 100 times after getting your ass kicked? No. Either you have to do it the next day, which I think is maybe what happens. Or the game, like, tends to respond to failure pretty well. It, like, then you click over into another progression track. So, like, I don't know if you can beat that guy. I remember trying a lot. Maybe in one of those things where I eventually gave up, or I did it, and then it's just go to the travel company still. I got my ass kicked yesterday, and Mom still has my allowance on the table.
Thank you, Rina-san.
Oh, crap. I forgot to bring in the trash canisters. I think Stephanie's doing that now. I usually take care of that, but... Someone called me as soon as I got home, and that just... My brain is a scattered thing. I wish there was a Kung Fu-style movie where they only did wrestling moves. Yeah, it's weird that doesn't exist, right? Like a movie that's an action movie that's in an all wrestling setting. Oh. Ooh.
You hungry?
Turquoise. Thank you for the sub.
She's eating.
She must have been very hungry.
Yeah, and she looks real happy. Thank you, Dio.
Let me play a song for you. Let me pause this. There we go. You reminded me, I actually need to stock my my game zone things with more shitty royalty-free footage. Yeah, I like this, okay. This is a pretty Phil Collins jam, but I like it, so. Ooh, red legs. Woo! 25 months, damn. Thank you for the resub. The turquoise, let me play this for you. Are you gonna leave this hingum be? Will you leave it all behind? Will you leave it all behind? Find a way, don't change on me. Thank you.
It's a giveaway, but nothing's free. Memories are all I need. Moving on with scars and healing. Things were wrong and now we're dealing. You told me that you're tired of feeling. Is having a change of heart a real thing? Having a change of heart. Are you gonna change your mind? Are you gonna change your mind? Are you gonna leave this incomplete? Will you leave it all behind? Will you leave it all behind? Find a way, don't change on me.
Man, one of these days, I'll get that right. Thank you, Laronic. One of these days, I'll remember to not start talking without unmuting my mic. So the name of that song for Kill Bunny was Changed by Great Good Fine OK. And yes, it's very pleasant. Yeah, I don't remember what I was ranting about apart from that. So, oh yeah, that's right. I was acknowledging that band was actually recommended to me by someone in stream chat. So they were dead on. That was a good sound. Just looking down. Yep, okay. All the audio sources that should be on are on. Dog. Alright, I think I'm gonna check out the travel agency, and then I'll probably be the end of the stream, depending on what goes on there. Getting pretty hungry. I'm trying to change my eating patterns a little bit. Experimenting. Ugh! See if I can, trick my body into losing a couple of pounds. It's, of course, all down to eating less and working out more, but damn it. It's annoying. Did you cummerbund? I'm not familiar with that. Finally snowing in the game. Yeah. It's actually accumulating on the ground, too. I get little crunchy, snowy steps. Man, that's good. Listening to, like, girls whisper at you for ASMR is tired as fuck. You know what's wired. Listening to the snowy footstep crunch sounds in a Dreamcast emulator when it occasionally pitches all the sound down because it's running weirdly. Oh, man, look at this dude.
Excuse me. Oh, Melina. I got some stupid business to take care of. Ask someone else, will you?
Some stupid business. Damn it. Stop that. His voice is fucked? Yeah. Go to the gym more? I should. But there's always interesting things to do at work. And, I like going to lunch with my friends. It's a relaxing thing to do in the middle of the day. I mean, working out is too. But, I just think it's there. Yeah. The Shenmue Snow Crunch is real galaxy brain material. Isn't it right here? Yeah. Closed. Oh. Kicking the door. Cutting out carbs and bread helps a lot. Yeah. That makes it easier to accidentally hit good diet goals. When you're just doing vegetables and meat.
What the hell is it? Hey. Shit. What's your problem?
Damn!
Stop!
QT time? Yeah.
What?
I'm sorry.
I totally hit that.
I'll explain.
I don't understand.
Sorry,
I'm hitting all of these and then it goes bonk. What the fuck? Like, I'm having to just mash it early. What the hell? I was like...
Sorry, sir. Hey, stop!
Damn!
God, I'm having to, like, hammer the buttons. Why, did he still get away?
Oh, man, where'd he go?
Where'd he go? Just stairs. Do you redo the sequence? Yeah, you do, okay. So it's just left right. I have to, like, memorize it. There's so much lag.
Who the hell is it?
Hey.
Shit.
What's your problem?
Damn! Stop!
Yeah, I got fucked. I knocked over everything. Alright, I'm prepared this time.
Ow.
Swoosh! So fast. Gaining on your ass.
Hey, you!
God, how quickly do they want you to hit this shit? I even know it's coming!
Damn.
And I can't hit it.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, wait!
No more, okay. That's okay, I got slow-mo now.
What the? Get out of my way!
Oh, spin, Kobe! This is an unfair advantage, but I'll take it.
No! I'm sorry! Forgive me! Give me my ticket! I don't have
it anymore!
Cut the crap!
I'm sorry!
No one who walks through the streets thinks this is weird. Oh shit! Alright. Damn, okay, alright. Disc 2 down. 2 out of 3 discs. Plug it on through, man. That's cool. Man, remember when you fucking swapped discs? That shit was hype as fuck! You got to like the end of disc 2 in Final Fantasy 7, you're like, fuck, this shit's getting real! You gotta get up, you gotta walk across the room, you're like, oh damn, oh damn, oh damn! I've always loved that. That, like, that flip the record moment. It's always really good for dramatic pacing, and I love the idea that you have to, like, do something in the room. Ah, well. Hope she's okay. Well, anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. This 2 down. We're all champions. I'll catch you next time.
I keep a company while she makes dinner. Tap dancing makes you very hungry, especially for burgers and Ora-Ida tater tots. Life would be perfect if I could eat tater tots every day and the whole world was covered with linoleum.
With so many special holiday messages to choose from, Hallmark has just the right cards to capture what you want to say this Christmas.
Hallmark has a way to make your holiday.
No matter who you